Premiere Pro has an automatic reframe feature, and it's incredibly easy to use. With Auto Reframe, Adobe Premiere can analyze your sequence and reframe everything to fit in a different size sequence. If you got a widescreen video of, say, 1920 by 1080, and you wanted it vertical, you could just auto reframe it. This way you can repurpose it for Instagram stories or TikTok. Adobe Premiere can actually analyze your footage and move the position of your sequence to follow the action. In the project panel, if you have a sequence highlighted, you can right click and you can select auto reframe sequence, or you can come up to the sequence menu and select auto reframe sequence. So now the auto reframe sequence dialog comes up, and I'm going to call this demo sequence vertical, and I'm going to choose my target aspect ratio of vertical 9x16. Motion tracking default is appropriate for most content. So if you know it's going to be slower motion, choose slower motion or faster motion if you know most of that clip is fast. I'm going to leave it on default. I have several clips on this timeline. And this option down here of clip nesting. So if you've done a lot of scaling and moving around of the shots, you might want to nest clips. It's going to preserve those adjustments, but then you have to reapply the transitions. So I'm going to say don't nest clips and then click create. So if you look over here in the project panel, Premiere Pro creates a duplicate sequence with the correct dimensions for the new aspect ratio. Every clip in the new sequence has the auto reframe effect applied. This duplicate sequence is saved in the auto reframe sequences folder in the root of the project panel. So if I play this back, you see how it reframed the sequence. So once your clips are auto reframed, you can scrub through the clip and see if you want to refine anything. So if you want to refine anything, you can go to your effects control tab, which is shift 5. Here you see auto reframe, and you can use the reframe scale if you like. You can use the reframe offset, moving the frame left and right or up and down. So now if there are parts where you think the framing could be better and you want to adjust them manually, you can come over here to the auto reframe effect. You can click on this box here that says overwrite generated path. And once you do that, all the keyframes that Premiere Pro has generated appear. And now all you have to do is hit the left and right arrows to go to the next keyframe, and you can decide which keyframes that you want to adjust. And so I'll go to this keyframe here, and I don't like where that position is. And so I'm just going to adjust my x-axis to bring this over, and I can keep on going to each of my keyframes and adjusting them until it is the way I like it. And if you want to get rid of a group of keyframes, just lasso them and hit delete, and you can make adjustments to your keyframes or to your liking. So this is a horizontal timeline I have here, and I have this one vertical clip on it. So I can auto reframe one clip on the timeline. All I have to do is come to my effects and search for auto reframe. Here it is. And I just drop it on my clip. And you can see that Premiere Pro has already done some auto reframing on it. I can come to my effects control panel and I can scale this down. Play with my reframe offset. And so this is what Premiere Pro did. And so if you have a timeline that has all horizontal clips and one vertical, you can reframe that one vertical clip and make your adjustments in the effects control panel. So as far as captions, sometimes it works out pretty good after you reframe a clip. But there are cases, like in this case here, it's a lower thirds, and it's a motion graphics template that was here in Premiere Pro. And so after I auto reframe the sequence, you see what it looks like now. You can see that the text and the shape in the background is out of alignment. They didn't move together. So now what I want to do is I want to actually pin this shape to the text itself. So I can come up here in the essential graphics and click on the shape, and it says responsive design position, and I want to pin that shape to the text, Rusty the dog. And then I'd like to kind of pin this to the left and bottom. So that's something called parenting. And now if I reframe my sequence, if you pin it to the video frame during the auto reframe, several things could happen. If, and in this case, if there's multiple layers. You have a text layer and a shape layer here. So basically they need to be kept together. So here's a complete auto reframe of that clip. The auto reframe is following the action and the text and the shape are staying together. If you want more tutorials just like this, click on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, like, share, and subscribe. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.